Alright. Revisiting my black coffers after the first time in a while. Sure, I'll try it. Let's see what you got. Okay. Whisper, draw some cards. Manic ending, subtlety, snark caster mage, da 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 da. Should have cast Knight's Whisper there. Should use that subtlety. Sorry, work subtlety. Top. It's four, so 6 mana total. Mm-hmm. Alright, get these reprieves in. Forest, go down these fatal pushes. And this hand do? Not a whole lot, honestly. This hand likewise doesn't do much. Keep. Back, leyline binding, planes. Supposed to put Becker Borg. Looks like they have a subtlety, so we'll force them to use it if they want to. Just counterspell. Sure. Good chance this gets countered. Spell Pierce, sure. Got. Mm-hmm. Sure. Put on one unknown. Why'd you tank so long on that? Go. Fiend's Tower. Interesting choice to leave in your deck. Opponent so far is drawing all gas, I guess. Yeah, Spell Pierce won't work. Okay. Drago against Blue-White Control seems good. Let's see to that one. Hope they don't have Spell Snare again. Of course they do. No, actually resolved. I'm shocked. Which counterspell do you choose this turn? Looks like they either have a solitude or something. Prismatic and then for four. I see. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So even if they don't counter this, we can still cast Alpine Man, sure. Cabal Coffers. Mm-hmm. Flame of Anor, Prismatic Ending. Nice to have the win over blue light control. Alright, match two. It's Gargamel, which I do believe we played against before, but I never remember what these people are on, so. Four lands, Fatal Push, Leyline Binding, probably a Snap Keep here. So. So, looks like we're up against good old fashioned scam. Malky, God of Lies. Fatal Push. They don't know about. Ah, fantastic. Gotta love freaking. Bless you. No idea what our opponent's up to over there. Mm-hmm. Goodbye Emrakul or goodbye Leyland Binding? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Okay, we're one short of that, so. So it looks like they're up to red, black BS stuff. Sand of Ganju. Keep. Thoughtseize. One ring, Karn. Alright, so the opponent has the coffers advantage on us, which is unfortunate. Karn will unfortunately get to resolve, so. Put a click tap wrong. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Probably gonna have 14, like a ton of mana here. Sure. Still have access to 7 mana. Sure. Playing this out even though we can't activate it. Cabal Coffers would probably be our best draw. Maybe an opposing Karn. So 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. well. So, Emrakul the Promised End coming in clutch. Alright, match number three. It's Jesus. 6, 7, 8. This is one of those awkward Cabal Coffers hands. Look at Mulligan. This hand is very much the same. This hand isn't good, but we'll keep it on 5. Alright, so we're up against Adnausem Combo, looks like. Take the sleight of hand. This will resolve, surprisingly. Ask your opponent. Fossils. Oracle. Four reprieves are better than 4 fatal pushes. Chalice. Okay. So this blue. Doesn't do enough. Definitely keeping this one. Mm-hmm. blanks about 8 cards in their deck. Sure. One way to win a match, I suppose. Alright, match number 4. It's not ideal, but we'll keep it. Burner scam. one. Deal with your only creature. It could be chilling on a death shadow potentially. Discard a card or sacrifice a permanent. Equal number of permanent cards in your graveyard and toughness. Okay, sure. Really need to find another land. Yep, that's the thing. One has one turn to top deck. Tribal Flames will do it. Alright. Our chalice and EEN, maybe both EEs. Leaves us with Ensnaring Bridge and the One Ring to go get. This were an Urborg, we could risk this hand, but we can't, so. Head. Sure. Shock in here, but case of Ragavan. Gotta do what we gotta do. It doesn't fetch, that's interesting. Well, one card in hand. Okay, pass. One or two. Got a 12. Alright, 4 I'll start to the league. Alright, match 5. We'll keep it a little less than ideal with a double Urborg, but... Okay, we're up against Hammer. This could be a tricky matchup. Okay, not sure 100% the correct sequencing on that, but... Draw Caldera. Okay. Alright, that was a heck of a game. Hand. Here we go. Mm-hmm. Surprised they just activate Stoneforge Mystic. Okay. They have two hammers, we're dead. I mean, there's nothing we can do about it. One. Sure. Not surprised that was the last card in their hand. was quite the insane 5-0. Right, quick wrap up after our 5-0 with Orzhov Coffers. So, a couple takeaways from this league is, number one, I do kind of agree with Andrea that 4 Coffers and 4 Orborg are probably too many. It just feels like we have a lot of hands where we have to mulligan that. So maybe cutting to 3 and 3 and either adding more solves or fetches or something, you know, keeping the land count high. The overall deck I like very much. You know, the 4 Fatal Push have come in pretty handy. The Knight's Whisper being a bridge card. Shoulder of Zeke came up a few times. Dam came up a few times. The Karn, One Ring, Shoulder of the Apocalypse. Leyline Binding was outstanding in a lot of situations. Emrakul, the Promised End. Single-handedly basically won us both the blue-white control matchup and the matchup against, or at least sealed the deal against, Rakdos Coffers. Sideboard package was pretty solid. The only one I wasn't quite sold on was Curse Totem. Activated abilities of creatures can't be activated, and obviously there's a reason this card exists in the sideboard. You know, decks like Yawgmoth, that kind of thing. So, we'll have to do more testing if we're ever going to get into this deck on a more regular basis. The 4 Reprieves helped out tremendously. Basically, single-handedly won us game 2 against the Leyline Adnausem draw. You know, allowing us to bounce Thassa's Oracle back to their hand when they had already gone for the Angel's Grace, Wolves of the Vault combo part of the deck. So, yeah. This deck is very impressive. I'm a lot more impressed with the deck now that I have a little bit better grasp of how to mulligan with the deck a little bit more. You know, last time we played Coffers on the channel with the mono black variant, and I thought the deck was very mediocre and overrated. I'm not sure if the One Ring had been printed yet at that point. It might have been, but the first time I played the deck, I was not very impressed with it. Obviously, kind of hard to argue with a 5-0. We did beat Hammer, and we did beat Blue White X Control, in addition to some other random decks. So, while the friendly leagues aren't the best of testing grounds, it did feel like a pretty clear, decisive 5-0. So, like this kind of modern content, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. I'll see you for our next video.